What's up, guys? Kevin Cage back with another XRP update. Let's dive right into this one. First off, hopefully some of you enjoyed the video I did yesterday. I was reading some funny comments as always saying, oh man, Cage is losing it. He's having a meltdown. And truth be told, when you know people with millions of dollars invested into this market, it's not a joke to me. Yesterday, for example, and this is not an exaggeration, I got roughly 20 to 30 texts from family members, from friends, and people I haven't even talked to in a while, freaking out about their investments. Now, some, yes, bought in 20 cent range, but some might be down even 50% for those that bought at 50 cents and 60 cents in this market. And I don't take that lightly by any means, so laugh all you want. And first off, this is one example on the screen of a text, a death threat to people that are in this ecosystem. This was sent to me from a family member this morning. Look at this. I'm offering you $500. Shouldn't be too much considering the recent pump to leave you alone. I'm not afraid to show up when you least expect it and see how my wrench works against your face, or maybe even wait for you to leave your home and take your belongings while you're not there to call the police. I'll be waiting for the money and watching you then. And then they have the payment address trying to get you to send your hard-earned cryptocurrency to them. This is not a joke, and yes, this is the Ledger breach, so they got some people's names, addresses, and even like phone numbers, emails, things of that nature. So do not fret. They sent this to thousands, hundreds of thousands of people, and I'm going to show you something that might be even a bigger conspiracy, and keep an open mind. Remember, as Aristotle says, it takes a truly intelligent mind to fully entertain a thought without fully accepting it, and that's the way I treat things here on this channel. So I don't say, this is it or this is it. I look at both sides, or at least I try to. You know, we humans, we're all, you know, hypocrites at the end of the day. But overall, if you guys are fearing about all this silly, you know, security nonsense, I'm just trying to reassure anybody, because if I can reassure one person that this is all good, this is a success to me. That's what I'm here for. So laugh all you guys want. And if anyone is actually smart and has done several years of research, you know, 2018, Ripple's been meeting with the SEC. We know that even 90% of Ripple's customers are outside of the United States, and 80% of the volume, the money flows of international remittances, for that matter, are outside of the United States. So the SEC, it doesn't really matter. We already have G20 nations, Singapore, Japan, the UK declare XRP is not a security. So we're fine. Like London, or, you know, the UK is one of the financial capitals of the world in the foreign exchange market. I'm not worried about XRP's future. I'm worried about the United States missing out on innovation. It's either going to happen there or they will make it happen elsewhere. And honestly, at this point, I think the United States may miss out unless all the world is truly a stage and this is some weird grand plan rollout. So I have a bunch of stuff to get through. And please understand, when XRP goes this low, it doesn't affect me one bit. I've been accumulating for 3 to 4 years. I'm trying to help the people that bought at 30 cents, 40 cents, 60 cents, because if I can help them, it's a win for me, big time. All right, so I'm going to show you a bunch of stuff in this one. Hopefully you enjoy. Right here, guys. So we got Crypto Mommy. Now, psychological warfare, essentially, this is already happening. This is much more than psychological. We have this Ledger hack and scams that are existing, and they build distrust in your self-custody, making you fearful, okay? And even the additional regulation occurring with that, it scares the people that don't know what they're doing. And so please get informed, work together, ask questions. We are here as a community. When price is low, there's going to be the children that attack each other and leave nasty comments on YouTube and Twitter, but the real people stand together, and that's what I'm trying to do. If you like XRP, you have a friend in me. I don't care if you are, you know, if you have $50 of XRP, or if you're a blogger, a YouTuber, you're on Twitter, or you're not at all involved, that's fine. We're all one community here, and we're learning together, all right? Now, remember, months ago, there was that huge FUD campaign, fear, uncertainty, and doubt, trying to get people to sell XRP when we are in the 20 cent range, saying, XRP, guys, we've been lied to. Ripple's a scam, blah, 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 blah. They got people to sell at the 20 cent range, then we went to 92 cents. This happens. We've seen this before. There's people that have been here 5 years, much longer than me in this market, and I'm just trying to be another voice to reassure people, all right? Right here, SEC lawsuit attempting to frame XRP as a security. Guys, it is either, you know, a commodity, a currency, a utility token. It will not be a security, maybe even a new framework for that matter. But other countries already named other assets non-security. They named them commodities, things of that nature, like Ethereum and Bitcoin. And please, we know how centralized those assets are. And yes, I hold Ethereum. I love Ethereum. Right here, the delistings today, and even the two biggest market makers on the trading desks, at least, stopped making markets for XRP. This is fear, guys. This is just part of the game. Anybody that says there's a bottom in this market, you can't say that, no matter what the chart says, because we are still in a 99% speculative market, meaning anything goes. Anything. So we have to keep an open mind. Scare people to sell their, or you know, to sell their XRP from their fear of losing their XRP, especially the ones who custody on exchanges. Everything I've invested, I'm willing to lose, and I'm swinging the bat in life. I've seen too much, and honestly, if you guys looked at the money that's involved in the space, this is just another great shakeout that we saw in the 90s, and I'm sure there's going to be some rude comments as always saying, oh man, I've heard this great shakeout term for 3 years. All right, sell your XRP. You're not doing me any favor by holding it, truly. Anybody sells it, I'm just buying lower XRP. That's completely fine. All right? So let's get into this. So right here, guys, XRP Crypto Wolf, a good buddy of mine, XRP will not be delisted by crypto exchanges, or at least those crypto exchanges that like XRP, because the SEC has announced a temporary safe harbor for broker dealers handling security tokens, even though XRP is not a security. So we'll see what happens. I mean, this drama is going to keep ensuing. And I'm curious what else they have in their arsenal, because it doesn't just happen one or two. FUD, the sphere of uncertainty and doubt, is most powerful when the charts are dropping. And of course, it's preceded by just, you know, one, two, three, compiling news. It works on people every single time like a charm. So if you guys don't believe it, if you think, you know, I'm an idiot or this is all wrong and too good to be true, get out. You know, this is not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. Do your own research. But at the end of the day, I make my own decisions and I hope you guys do too. Take this information. If you disagree with me and make better decisions, awesome. All right? So obviously we're going to keep an eye on this, but just understand we have the new SEC chairman that was appointed today, and he's crypto friendly. We have all these people. We had the former CFTC chairman who's an advisor for Ripple and represents Ripple with the law firm. You know, they've been meeting with the Trump administration. Like, there's just so many things they've been doing, and they've had their ducks in the row, and it seems like the SEC is trying to make an example out of Ripple first. And I'm curious what other tactics they have left in their arsenal. All right, next, I want to show you this video clip. We're going to show you 1 minute before we keep going. Mr. Level Up, my buddy, and we're going to show this. So this was 2 weeks ago, his thoughts. Now, keep in mind, he's the one that got me and saved me because I literally sold about like several hundred thousand Algo, Algorand, and even a little Luna at the time on September 1st when he talked to me at night. I uploaded a video in the morning as soon as I could and just set it to go. And he literally saved me. And he was calling for a drop. Everybody called him an idiot because it only went down, like the alts went down like 30, 40%. Some were down 60, 70%, like, you know, FET and Kava. But they've just been laughing at him. And he's like, we're still going. It didn't happen yet. That wasn't it. And, you know, now it's happening and people, you know, you don't have to believe it. You can say, oh, he didn't predict a lawsuit. That's fine. But just listen to this first minute, all right? And, you know, not everybody's meant to, so that's fine.
Here's the worst scenario that is going to piss retailers off and really make them depressed. You want to, this is what, think about this. They put money and they're hoping that XRP takes off and stuff like that, but it ends up turning back down and we had one more move in this bear market still.
And so he's bullish as can be. He's bullish, you know, more bullish than anybody, $10 plus, $50 plus. But all he's saying is we had one more dip that most people didn't see. That's all. It's just one little cup to form.
Right. Even though that was like a bull, it creates a bear scenario right now, just a short-term bear scenario. It then brings XRP all the way down underneath 20 cents to 15 cents. And it's a slow moving.
And so we've only wicked to about 20 cents that I've seen on exchanges. So the question is, are we done? Now, some people even see a potential bounce, like I see a potential bounce that we could go back into the mid 30s as well. So I'm still watching. But at the end of the day, I have my cash on the side since September 1st. I've been swing trading, but I'm not the one worried and hurting. My portfolio is completely fine.
And while it's doing that, we're going in lockdown. People are losing jobs, income, they need to pay their bills. Now they bought higher, now their portfolio just dropped 50 to 60 to 70%, right?
And that hurt my stomach watching our portfolio, my long-term holdings of XRP. Now, I know some guys, you know, 15 cents is their break even or 20 cents, but some people don't break even until 30, 40 cents, at least the newcomers. And guys, you will be fine in the future. This is just part of it. This is a battle scar. This is gonna be fun in the future. We're gonna laugh at this, but it still hurts our stomach and hits you in the gut when you see your portfolio go down 50%, whether it's $2,000 invested or $200,000. It hurts, but just understand this is merely temporary and I'm just using this as a dollar cost average opportunity to buy lower if it helps you lower it or just even accumulate more. It's a win-win.
So now their portfolio is down even low. It depends where they bought, but you guys get what I'm saying. So now they have 80%, only like 20 to 30% of what they originally had. They are struggling job-wise. They don't have any income coming in. It's almost putting them in a position, which they don't want to do, and it's going to bother the hell out of them, to sell their assets to get by in life. I'm not saying that that's what's going to happen to everybody, but I'm just saying that's a scenario that how this would unfold could play out. So I talk about it because I'd rather you guys be awake to it to kind of work around the system. See, I try to be aware of the game that's being played right.
And we've both had our mistakes, but I just really like that perspective. That was a live stream he did. We can see in the bottom left. Hopefully you can see it. It's December 15th, so about 2 weeks ago. So anyways, we're going to keep moving and obviously consider everything that's happening, even, you know, Crypto Mommy's tweet of all of this, and there's much more ahead. I'm pretty certain of it. I don't think we're out of the, you know, the woods quite yet. All right, right here, guys, breaking. So we have a new pro-crypto SEC chairman appointed. So we're seeing this. And of course, I'm sure many of you guys have read this, what it means for crypto, these lawsuits, the commentary, you get it. This future is coming. Why on earth did you see hundreds of millions of dollars being invested by these institutions? Why are they building custody solutions to secure digital assets? Why are they working on tokenization of securities to make so we have asset fractionalization and the benefits of crypto and DLT in the stock market? Why did NASDAQ already integrate with R3, and R3 is who's the shareholder of R3? SBI. SBI owns Ripple and R3. This is just a game. And for those of us that actually stay calm and research and are, you know, controlling our emotions, we're going to win. And that's just how I see it. And I cannot wait because, you know, maybe in the next couple of weeks, we're still going to be down or something like that. And you guys are going to lose faith. I'm not. I've already seen too much. And I know 2021 will be a very interesting year. They're going to drag it out as long as possible and make everybody doubt their investment. Now, the question is, how long will they do it? And a question you should be asking yourself is, how long are you willing to wait? Because this wasn't supposed to be easy, and victory is going to be that much sweeter. Right here, guys. So we have Lionel. He was formerly in banking, if you guys want to know. Really smart guy. He's a goofball. He's pretty funny, honestly. And he always sends me some really good things. And I mean, most people don't really have a good understanding, and he's really helped me get a better understanding of the banking space. So right here, so by Decrypt, the SEC paper shows settlements between Ripple and R3 was over $240 million. As we remember, years ago, there was a promise that R3 was going to get about $5 billion with a B. That's 5% of the entire float of XRP. And yet people say that there was no plan for R3 to use XRP. There absolutely was. Katao of SBI, they've all planned this, this brother-sister relationship. Ripple, this is low-value, high-volume payments. R3, this is capital markets, trade finance. This makes the remittance market look like a baby. This is the true cross-border flow. I'm talking trillions. So if R3 ever were to use even XRP, just a little bit, this would be absolutely massive. Now, we know the R3 CEO, David Rutter, cannot discuss this whatsoever. Behind R3, these are the Lehman boys. These are the Wall Street boys bringing crypto to this space. And again, if you've watched, not my stupid rants, but if you've watched the information I've shared in the hundreds of videos the past few years, you would see what's happening. All right? So we can go through this. I'll just speed through this because I have some interesting things to show you. SEC papers shed new light on the 2019 settlement because we never knew how much. Paper indicates that a settlement between Ripple and obviously an enterprise firm was valued at $240 million. It was obviously R3 because we keep up with it. The SEC filed papers as part of the lawsuit against Ripple in which it accused Ripple of conducting an unregistered digital asset securities offering. Remember, EOS, all these cryptos that sold crypto in early way that kind of looked like a security, they get slapped on the wrist, they get a fine, and that's what happens, all right? If you really believe that XRP, one of the longest standing digital assets, went this long, worked with lobbyists, has an office in DC, is actually going to disappear entirely now in 2020, that's a joke to me. This is all a game, and you can either fall for it or not, and we're going to see who's right in the end. All right? The companies were involved in litigation, blah, 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 blah. You guys can see this during the time. You can see Ripple raised over $1.3 billion through this offering. So they're going through. They're going hard at them. You can keep an eye on this. I mean, look at this. Like, we're talking millions, if not billions. And, you know, they gave the firm an option to buy up to 5 billion XRP at a discount. And there was, you know, some disputes in the meantime. So we've gone through this many times, but I just want to show you and wonder if there was any XRP or, you know, even, you know, company equity, what was involved in this settlement? Because obviously it remains to be confidential. All right. So we can write here, remain confidential. And both sides look forward to putting these disputes behind them. Just another day in the life. All right. Next. Right here, guys, XRP Crypto Wolf. We have SBI's statement on the proceedings against the company Ripple. And this is what I was saying in the beginning of the video. Over 90% of Ripple's customer base are outside of the US. They have their new fintech, or their new HQ, regional headquarters, I should say, in Dubai. The UAE, we've heard the commentary. We know what they're doing in Brazil is central to their on-demand liquidity rollout. The BRICS nations, they had, you know, well over 50% of India in the pipeline as a customer in 2018. So, yeah, you guys can be fearful. You can sell your XRP lower. Oh, well, but I'm not buying it. And I'm sure the smart people here are not either. Right here. So XRP underscore productions, he is satire. He puts out satirical posts, and many people, this is not like, you know, most things are not real, but I love this. And this is such a true tweet. Raise your hand if your XRP holdings have never been more hurt than when the SEC stepped in to save you after 8 years. The SEC always says we're here to protect investors. They damaged more investors than ever before. If they were going to make a move on Ripple, they would have done so years ago. Do not buy this crap, please. We have the current SEC chairman, literally pro crypto. This Jay Clayton delayed it. This is just a game. And what the game is this. And whoever, you know, Jay Clayton, I'm sure he's on somebody's payroll, guys. This world is about money. And these alpha males are controlling people and manipulating them, threatening them. Who knows the details? All I'm saying is, right when Jay Clayton's leaving, a new administration's coming, they roll all of this out in December. If you heard Charles Hoskinson, a genius, his thoughts, the founder of Cardano, his thoughts on all of this, he had some very, very good speculation. He's done some live streams that are like 30 minute plus, and they gave me some really good insights because he's actually in the know, believe it or not. And, you know, I already showed you that 1 minute clip I uploaded a few days ago. Watch that 1 minute video of Charles. It will absolutely blow your mind. All right. Now this is what I wanted to share. People tell me to shut up about crypto because XRP is down. It's at 20 cents. It's at 25 cents. It's 30 cents. It used to be 60, blah, 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 blah. That's exactly why I'm loud right now and making these videos. Why would I want to shill XRP when it's a dollar? This is the opportunity right now. Those that buy at 25 cents, if we go lower, awesome. But I'm just using this as an example. Double their investment when they go back to 50 cents. You put in 10 grand, you make 10 grand. You're at 20K. You 4X it at $1 and 40X it when XRP is at $10. There's even bigger gains for those that are able to buy lower than that. So this is why I'm excited. And if you guys know James Rule XRP in the XRP community, look him up on YouTube and give him a subscribe. He doubled or even tripled his 401k that he had with Coca-Cola before leaving. So this is not a joke. And yes, we witnessed that. And yes, now if, you know, he's still holding, he's down. But we know where XRP is going in the future. So this is with iTrust Capital once again. And if you expect the crypto market's going to grow significantly in the future, having crypto, gold, silver in your Roth IRA means that all of your gains in your account will grow 100% tax-free. I literally had some XRP sold at 60 cents and I bought back last night. So I'm fine with it. And it was only just a little bit. I have a rule of thumb where I never risk my long-term holdings. I had my girlfriend sell some XRP a while back, but then it went up higher, but now we just bought back lower. So it's all good and great. And I do not let her touch her long-term holdings under any circumstances either. And I don't know about you, but I plan to withdraw some of my millions completely tax-free. I'm not looking to pay short-term, long-term capital gains, 15%, 35%, which with millions of dollars could be equivalent to hundreds of thousands of dollars down the road. So links are in the video description. Very few are going to take advantage of this opportunity. Well, the price is low, but those that do are going to have the biggest upside. See you in the next video.